Today's openings begin with Twilight Bavarian Dark Lager from Black Wheat Brewing in Brandon, Manitoba. They describe it as a Bavarian-style dark lager with subtle notes of chocolate and espresso, featuring a mild roasty aroma and a smooth lager finish. Let's see what we've got today. This says receiver board. Okay. What am I receiving? Oh. There's actually two circuit boards in here. This one is V plus and a power switch, an inductor, L, R, F, B, V plus, and antenna. Oh! Left, right, forward, back. That looks like some sort of a remote control receiver. And its partner has four push buttons, another inductor, power switch, LED. Actually, that looks like an inductor as well. V plus, V minus, and antenna. So if I remember correctly from ordering, this is in fact a remote control pair for anything, I suppose. And I believe the 27M on there refers to the frequency. So 27 megahertz band, aka CB radio band. Four channel RC remote control, 27 megahertz circuit, PCB transmitter and receiver board parts. Yep, that's exactly what it is. I paid $3.31 with free shipping. So pretty much no information about it down here. Material, copper. Color, as photos shown, includes one set. Looks like there are other sellers with the same thing for pretty much the same thing price, or today anyway, a little bit less. Off to a good start. What's next? It says ratchet wrench screwdriver bit set. Well, I do like tools. Yeah, that's what we've got. We have a set of screwdriver bits. Oh, these are not the same as these little ones. These are the more heavy-duty ones. I think those are quarter-inch, typically. And a little ratchet handle. Oh, that's nice. And I think, does it go... Yeah. Well, that's a fairly satisfying little tool. So the thing that prompted me to go searching for something like that was when I was putting together these little lights. Remember, there's a screw down and underneath in the yoke here, down in that hole that I couldn't get to. But I think, yeah, that should be able to get in there and do it. Hopefully it's got a small enough bit to get onto those. If not, I do have other sets of this type of bit that might be able to get into a smaller screw. Ratchet wrench screwdriver bit set, right angle offset hand ratchet spanner kit. Wow, that's actually more than I thought I paid for it. $9.45. But at least it had free shipping. There's the assortment of bits that it came with. Three straights, four Phillips, and three Torx. Not a bad assortment, typically. Although, if somebody was selling it in Canada, they would have to include a Robertson or two in that as well. Right, next thing in. This says just order number LP, whatever, whatever. It doesn't actually say what it is. So, in we go. Okay. A nice little protective case. A little DuPont II mini JST. What are you? Oh, I know what this is. This is a little touchscreen display board with an ESP32 on the back of it. What else do we have built into this? We have a speaker connector. We have a reset and boot button there. We have a few GPIOs over there and a few more over there. We have a RGB LED. We have, what are you, a micro SD there, USB connection there, and serial there, TX, RX, and ground and whatnot. This is what's been dubbed the cheap yellow display. If you listen to Simple Electronics podcast from about a week ago, he had Brian Locke on, and one of the things they discussed was that Brian and some members of his Discord have been working on building a sort of software ecosystem around this little board, which they have dubbed the Cheap Yellow Display. I will put some links to some of the stuff about it, but I think this is going to be a very useful, handy little display module, especially with all of the software that, that these smart people have been building around it. And hopefully it doesn't start getting too expensive as everybody starts noticing it. They seem to be fairly abundant and fairly cheap right now. Well, let me show you. ESP32 Arduino LVGL Wi-Fi and Bluetooth development board, 2.8 inch, 240 by 320 smart display screen, 2.8 inch LCD TFT module with touch room. So this is not the cheapest one that I see today, but again, when I ordered it, it was about the cheapest in Canadian dollars, $12.65 plus almost $7.50 shipping. But there are several sellers on AliExpress that have the same board, and I will link you to this one. So this listing seems to have some software available for download, but there is a better source, and that better place would be here, Brian's GitHub. He's compiling the stuff that the group of people are all coming up with and putting together here. There is the original documentation on all the chips on the board. There are 3D printing modules. There's config files for the display. There's a bunch of example codes, and there's even some hardware mods. It's all described very well here. And yeah, there's going to be a lot more coming. I've been noticing what they've been doing on Discord, and yeah, it is a cool little board, and I think there's quite a lot of information here. Also, if the link that I put in the description doesn't find you the least expensive one, here's a few other links to buy the same one if you prefer. Wow, 3 for 3 interesting things. Let's see if the trend continues. This thing does say what's in it, but it says it in Chinese, so that doesn't really help me. Definitely designed for machine inserting. What are these? Oh, these I think are sockets to take the cherry style keyboard keys. Hang on, let me just grab some. At least I hope that's what they are. I hope I've ordered what I think I ordered. Let's just grab one of these out of here. I'm not nearly as smooth at pulling these out as a pick and place machine would be. So these solder onto the circuit board, and then the keys theoretically just plug into it. Yeah, that way you can replace the keys if they wear out, or if you prefer a different type or something like that. And then this is a standard footprint. But yeah, that's what they're for. And if you have one of those funky mechanical keyboards, it's likely full of these already. So since I have these keys, just as, you know, push button switches for some unsuspecting future project, I decided, once I learned the existence of these, that I ought to get some of those too.
Kailh, whatever, I don't know how you pronounce that. Hot swapping PCB sockets, PCB socket for MX Cherry, Gateron Outemu Kailh switches for low profile 1350 chocolate access. That's a whole bunch of keywords that I don't know anything about. Yeah, it looks like there's two different kinds. I bought 30 of these ones for $6.67 each. Did I buy 30? No, I bought 70 of them. Okay, so 70 for $11.37. Not too much information about them down here, except for they're apparently USB compatible. Sure.
Which brings us to the last and largest of the packages. It feels like this one actually has two pieces in it. Again, the only information on the outside of the package is in code, so that doesn't really help me any. So what do we have here? Oh, intelligent electric soldering iron from KAIWEETS. Oh, this wasn't supposed to be a mailbag item. This is a demonstration or Well, they call it a review, but as I've said many times, I don't do reviews around here. I will demonstrate products, but I don't do reviews. So, just as a quick overview here, I guess, it comes with a 65-watt USB-C power supply, USB-A and USB-C, and what do we say on the back of the box? It's model KETS02, can do up to 420 degrees Celsius, power from between 9 and 20 volts DC, USB-C input, 65 watts power delivery to power the thing. This kit has 6 pieces of soldering iron tips included. Got instructions on the box for how to install the soldering tips. Not much else on the box, right? Well, I guess I should go to their website. And since this is clearly a promotional item, I guess I will give it its own video coming up, because that's what I would have agreed to them to do.
Oh, KAIWEETS KETS02 Smart Digital Soldering Iron Kit. Currently, they're selling it for $120 Canadian on their website. If you're buying things in American dollars, knock about 35% off that. I think that's what the current exchange rate is right now. Rapid heating up to 420 degrees Celsius. Yeah, we saw that on the box. Built-in intelligent chip that can provide real-time temperature compensation, precision temperature control, and temperature calibration, and all that good stuff. It's got an OLED screen on it for displaying that. It can work on anything from 9 up to 20 volts, and it did say on the box that it uses USB-C power delivery for that. Adjustable voltage, rapid heating, display, right-to-left hand switch, child lock. So to get the full 65 watts, you need to run it at 20 volts, which is a power delivery voltage, so that's cool. And at 65 watts, it only takes 8 seconds to heat up. Okay, so there is the 6 tips that that mine came with. I'll be looking closer at it in the coming weeks, so we'll just have to hold off. But if you want to see all this stuff, there's a link down below, of course.
Well, would you look at that? Here are all the things from today's Mailbag Monday haul. Quite a variety, and I think this is one of the better ones that I've had in a while, actually. There's no duds in it at all. Everything is either interesting or useful. I'm pretty pleased with this. So we have this cheap little set of remote control boards, 4-channel 27 megahertz remote. It's not going to be the highest quality, but it was only a few dollars, and it should be fun to play with. This little low-profile ratchet and its bit set will come in handy. It's one of those things that you're not going to use very often, but when you need something like that, it's pretty much the only tool that can get in there. So that will come in handy. These little key switch sockets, those will, at some point, I will find a project that I want to use those key switches for, and I will be happy that I've got them in stock. The cheap yellow display. Again, I want to thank Brian and the group of people that have gathered around this project to make software available for what looks like a powerful little display board and should be very useful. And of course, KAIWEETS has sent me this to take a look at, so I will be showing that soldering iron off in the next few weeks. Thanks everybody for joining in as always. Thanks to my Patreon supporters and my YouTube channel members for helping me fund all this stuff, keep the lights on, keep the beer fridge full. And for everybody else, feel free to comment down below. Questions, as always, I appreciate that. Thanks for watching. I will talk to you later.